Praise you, Jesus. praise your God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. For the churches of Jehovah, oh Father God, I pray, Lord, that you'll be with the pastors, oh Father God. You strengthen them, oh Father, in such a time, oh God. You strengthen the people, oh Father. You strengthen your people, oh God, to totally lean on you, to lean upon you, Father, to depend on you, oh God, not to lose heart, oh Father God. Oh, strengthen them in the name of Father God. Let there be shift in their spirit, oh Father. Let there be shift in the spirit, oh Father God. Oh, let them be even more strongly attached to you, oh Father God. Strongly walk with you, oh God. Strongly connected to you, oh Father. Hallelujah. I come against, Lord. I come against this COVID-19 in JB, oh Father God. You let your healing prevail, oh Father God. Let your healing prevail, oh God. The mighty name of Jesus, let your healing prevail, oh God. I come against, Lord. I come against this COVID-19 in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we pray for revival among the churches, oh Father. We pray for the outpouring of your Holy Spirit. I pray, oh God, the Holy Spirit will move, oh Father. Move, oh God, such a time as this, oh Father. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, as we prepare our hearts to give our tithes and offering, we will put a number on the screen. If you wish to transfer your tithes and offering, please transfer to this number. And if you put in a cash deposit, please send your receipts to this number. Even as you give, let us pray now. Father, we thank you, Lord, even for the people who are giving, oh Father. We pray that you bless their going out and their coming in, oh Father. Provide the need, meet your need, oh Father God. Bless them, oh Father. Let them lack no good thing, oh Father. Provide the need, oh Father. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we thank you, Lord. We want to honor you with our tithes and offering, oh Father. You bless the cheerful giver, oh Father God. Oh yes, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Father, we want to thank you, Lord, for the providence, for your blessing, oh Father. Even as we give unto you, O God, even as your people give unto you, bless them, Lord, 100-fold, 200-fold, 300-fold, O Father. Bless them, Father God. Bless them, Father God. Bless them. Provide the need, Lord. Meet the need, O Father God. Bless their going out and their coming in. We know that your hand of blessing and favor is upon us. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name.
We will be having our English room basis as usual online on Tuesday at 8:30 p.m. followed by Groundbreakers and Kids Church will be on Friday at 8 p.m. And now we also have a prayer and English helpline especially for you. If you are here for the first time and if you have any prayer needs, please do get in touch with us. Our pastor and engaged group leaders will get in touch with you. We love you. We are here for you. For any other further information, please get in touch with your engaged home-based leaders. Now, for the best part of the stream, are you ready to hear God's word? It's going to be a powerful time of God encounter. So let's put our hands together and welcome our pastor Amanda.
Hi, Shalom Church. A very blessed evening to all of you. You know, I greet all of you in the name of Jesus Christ. உங்களை அனைவரும் நான் இயேசுவின் அன்பான நாமத்தில் நான் வரவேற்கிறேன். இன்னும் இந்த நேரத்தில் நீங்கள் அப்படியாக இந்த ஸ்ட்ரீமில் கனெக்ட் பண்ணி இருக்கிற வேலையும் ஈவன் எஸ் யூ கனெக்டட் together with us via the stream. I want you to know that the presence of God is there with you, just enveloping you. And wherever you are, come on, just lift up your hands and just take a moment today. Come on, just take a moment to thank God. And let's be grateful to God for all the things that He has done in our lives. and all the things that He is about to do. Come on, let's just thank the Lord. Let's just be grateful to God for His faithfulness over our life. அப்படியாக நன்றி உள்ளத்தோட ஆண்டவரே ஸ்தோத்திரத்தோட நன்றி உள்ளத்தோட அப்படியாக துதிகர நாம் அப்படியாக செலுத்துவோம் அவரோட உண்மைத்துவத்துக்காக. Let's thank God for His faithfulness, for His loving kindness that is unfailing, for His loving kindness that is everlasting, church. Oh shikiyata mabrakatala masibrabakayanda. Father, this evening, oh God, we give you all the glory and honor. Father, we thank you for your faithfulness in our life, oh Father. God, when we think about you, we think about your faithfulness, oh God. When we think about you, we think about your faithfulness and your loving kindness, oh Father. God, we bring to remembrance, oh God, all your promises in our life, oh Father. We thank you, oh Lord. Father, we give you all the glory and honor, oh Father, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. You know, church, very quickly, if you have your Bibles with you, turn with me to the book of 1 Thessalonians, chapter 5, verses 16 to 18. Amen? Amen? 1 Thessalonians, 5th Adhigaram, 16-ல் இருந்து 18th வசனத்தை நம்ம அப்படியாக படிப்போம். Rejoice always, pray without ceasing, in everything give thanks. Amen? For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you. அப்படியாக 1 தெசலோனிக்கா 5th அதிகாரத்துல 17-18 வசனத்துல போட்டிருக்குது, எப்பொழுதும் சந்தோஷமாக இருங்கள், இடைவிடாமல் ஜபம் பண்ணுங்கள், எல்லாவற்றிலையும் சோஸ்திரம் செய்யுங்கள். அப்படி செய்வது கிறிஸ்து இயேசுக்குள் உங்களை குறித்து தேவனுடைய சித்தமாக இருக்கிறது. ஆமென். ஆமென். பாருங்க, வேதம் அப்படியாக திட்டம் தெளிவாக போட்டிருக்குது. நான் ஆண்டவரோட சித்தம் நம்ம வாழ்க்கல என்ன? What is the will of God for us? What is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you and I? That is to rejoice always, that is to pray without ceasing, and in everything we are called, we are urged, we are instructed to give thanks to the Lord. Amen. Amen. You know, today I want to speak to you about gratitude. You know, being thankful. When we speak about being thankful, it's about being thankful for all things at all times. Amen. Being thankful, church, is the key to being joyful and to being blessed. Amen. I know sometimes it's very difficult to praise God at all times. It's very difficult, especially during difficult circumstances, in times of weariness, in times of uncertainty, to actually rejoice always. Amen. To pray without ceasing. But the word of God states that this is the will of God for us in Christ Jesus. Amen. How do we rejoice always? How do we pray without ceasing? Amen. The key is to be thankful. That is the main thing, the key that will enable us to be joyful at all times, in respective of our circumstances, and to be blessed. Amen. You see, church, gratitude na nandri ullam. You know, or nandri ullathoda. Gratitude is an attitude of the heart. Iridhe oda anugumurayaga irukkudhu. Amen. It is developed through consistent choices and heart responses. Number thanadoram edukkra or consistentana choice mulimum nammoda heart, nammoda iridiyam, நம்ம போகிற கடந்து போகிற வாழ்க்கை பயணத்துல கடந்து போகிற ஒவ்வொரு சூழ்நிலையும் நம்ம நம்மளோட இறுதியம் எப்படி ரெஸ்பாண்ட் பண்ணுகிறது அந்த சூழ்நிலைக்கு. What is the reflection of the heart, responses of our heart during our circumstances? You know, it's an attitude of the heart, that is gratitude. Gratitude is a biblical characteristic. It is a part of the foundation of our lives that will enable us to grow into spiritual maturity. Amen. Amen. நன்றி நன்றி உள்ளம் சொல்லும் போது அது தேவன் வார்த்தையில இருக்கிற ஒரு கேரக்டரிஸ்டிக் எப்படி சொல்லுவாங்க குணாதேசியமா குணாதேசியமாக இருக்குது அது நம்மளோட வாழ்க்கையின் அஸ்திபாரமாக அது இருக்கணும் ஏன் தெரியுமாங்க நன்றி உள்ளம் இல்லாம நம்ம ஆவிக்குரிய காரியத்துல நம்ம மெச்சுவராக நம்ம ஆக முடியாது நம்ம முதிர்ச்சி முதிர்ச்சியா முதிர்ச்சி நம்ம அடைய முடியாது ஆமென் ஆமென் டுடே வெரி குவிக்லி ஐ எம் கோயிங் டு ஸ்பீக் டு யூ அபௌட் 3 இன்கிரெடிபிள் டைமென்ஷன்ஸ் தட் a heart of gratitude positions you and I to receive ஆமென் ஆமென் you know number 1 when we have a heart of gratitude in our life நம்ம வாழ்க்கையில நம்ம ஒரு நன்றி உள்ளத்தோட தினதோறும் நம்ம வாழும் பொழுது வேதத்துல எழுதுனது போல நம்ம எப்பொழுதுமே சந்தோஷமாக இருக்கும் பொழுது இடைவிடாம ஜபம் பண்ணும் பொழுது நம்ம அப்படியாக எல்லாவற்றிலையும் நம்ம சோஸ்திரம் செய்யும் பொழுது வேதம் சொல்றது அது வந்து கிறிஸ்து இயேசுக்குள் குறித்து அது தேவனுடைய சித்தமாக நம்மளுக்கு இருக்கிறது ஆமென் ஆமென் நம்ம அப்படிப்பட்ட ஜனங்களாக இருக்கும் பொழுது மூன்று காரியங்கள் நம்ம ஒரு மூன்று டைமென்ஷன்ஸ் the heart of gratitude will position us to receive amen everybody following me number 1 to see the impossible become possible amen tap the person next to you and say to see the impossible become possible how do we say that in Tamil to see the impossible முடியாத காரியங்கள் அது பாசிபிளாக ஆகிறது அதை நம்ம பார்க்க முடியும் அதை நம்ம பெற்றுக்கொள்ள முடியும் எப்பொழுது நம்ம நன்றி உள்ளத்தோட இருக்கிற ஜனங்களாக இருக்கும் பொழுது ஆமென் ஆமென் you see when we are grateful church and when we have a heart of gratitude it moves the heart of God to intervene on our behalf amen it's called the divine intervention of God if we want to see things in our life to shift from impossibilities to possibilities we need the divine intervention of God amen amen you see today I'll be talking to you about a few men of God who were different in their spirit who had this attitude of the heart that was marked with honor and gratitude for God amen நன்றி உள்ளத்தோட அவங்க வாழ்ந்து கொண்ட மனிதர்களாக இருந்தாங்க that a grateful heart is positioned to receive the miraculous transformation of seemingly impossible circumstances. Amen. Today, how is our heart positioned? Let us check our hearts. Is our hearts really thankful? Are we people with thankful hearts? Are we people with a heart of gratitude? Because it shows the attitude of our hearts. Or are we people with a heart that is full of complaints, bitterness and murmurings? It's something that we got to check. Amen? If we want to see a shift of impossibilities in our lives becoming and transforming to a place of possibility and we want to see the hand of God moving on our behalf and if we want to witness the divine intervention of God, we need to have a grateful heart. Amen? Amen? Let's turn to the book of Acts chapter 16. அப்போஸ்தலர் 16வது அதிகாரத்துக்கு அப்படியே நம்ம திருப்பி கொள்வோமாக you see the book of acts chapter 16 you know 2 weeks ago அப்படியே ஆகஸ்ட் 16ல வந்து நம்ம வீக்கெண்ட் லைவ் லைவ் செஷன்ஸ்லயோ நம்மளோட தனிப்பட்ட முறையில எங்கேஜ் பேஸ் செஷன்ஸ்லயே வந்து இந்த அதிகாரத்தை வந்து நம்ம இன்னும் ஆழமாக அப்ப பார்த்தோம் it is a continuation from there. Amen. You see, Acts chapter 16 reveals the power of gratitude, thanksgiving, and praise in the midst of hardship and persecution. Acts 16th அதிகாரம் நம்ம படிக்கும்போது அது நன்றி உள்ளிட்ட வல்லமையும் நம்ம ஆண்டர சோஸ்திருக்கும் போதும் ஆண்டர துதிக்கும் பொழுதும் நெருக்கத்தின் நேரத்துல உபத்திரத்தின் நேரத்துல நம்ம ஆண்டர துதித்து பாடி ஆண்டர சோஸ்தரித்து நன்றி உள்ள ஆண்டர நாமத்தை நம்ம கனப்படுத்தும் பொழுது அதோட வல்லமை என்னன்னு சொல்லி நம்ம எக்ஸ் 16ல அப்போஸ்தலர் 16 அதிகாரத்துல நம்ம பார்த்தோம். ஆமென். அதே போல இன்னைக்கு நம்ம அது ஒன்னு தொடர்ந்து நம்ம பார்க்க போறோம். ஆமென். A personal reflection of it. You know, speaking about Acts chapter 16, ஒரு ஓவர்வியூ உங்களுக்கு கொடுக்கணும்னா தெரியாதவங்களுக்கு நீங்க எங்களோட வீக்கெண்ட் லைவ் செஷன் நீங்க ஜாயின் பண்ணாட்டி இல்ல இஃப் யூ நெவர் பீன் டு எங்கேஜ் பேஸ்ட் செஷன்ஸ் this is an overview for you. Amen. You see, Paul, this is Paul, about Paul, Silas, and about the Macedonian Paul. You know, Paul was forbidden by the Spirit of God to preach the word in Asia. Paul சில இடத்துக்கு போய் ஆண்டோட சுவிசேஷத்தை அவர் சொல்றோம்னு சொல்லி அவர் திட்டமிட்டு இருந்தார். ஆனா ஆண்டோட ஆவியானவர் அந்த இடத்துக்கு போகாம அவரை தடுத்து விட்டார். பால் ஆசியாக்கு போகணும்னு இருந்தா ஆனா ஆவியானவர் தடுத்தாரு அங்க போகக்கூடாதுன்னு சொல்லி அது நேரம் இல்லைன்னு சொல்லி he was forbidden to preach in Asia. And then he tried to go to Mysia. From then he tried to go to Bithynia. Even then the Spirit of God did not permit them. Amen. Amen. And then in Troas la irukumbodhu Paul ஒரு ராத்திரி நேரத்துல Paul அப்படியாக ஒரு தரிசனத்தை காணினார். Paul had a vision in the night. You know, if you look at verse 10, if you have your Bibles, you can just go through it, okay? Had a vision, a man from Macedonia calling him to come and saying in that vision, come and help us, you know. And then they decided, they felt, they were convicted that the Lord is calling them to Macedonia to reach out to the people there. You know, once they traveled to Philippi, and once they were there, you know, Paul and Silas endured persecution. If we go to the scriptures, we can see that Paul and Silas endured persecution when they preached the gospel to the people of Philippi. They were beaten, they were imprisoned by people who were threatened by the power of deliverance their message carried. Right? Right? Yet in the midst of persecution, pain, captivity, and injustice, Paul and Silas still did not complain or speak out of fear, even in that kind of situation and circumstance. Instead, how they responded was, they let gratitude and praise for God to pour out of their hearts in prayer and songs of worship. Amen. Amen. And this unlocked the miraculous, impossible situation to become possible. They saw the divine intervention of God in that place. Amen. Amen. You know, let's read that verse, okay, and then I'll explain even more further. Acts chapter 16, verses 20 to 26. Everybody following me? அப்போஸ்தலர் 16 அதிகாரம் 20ல இருந்து 26 வசனத்துல போட்டிருக்குது. I'll read in English, okay? They brought them before the magistrates and said, these men are Jews and are throwing our city into an uproar by advocating customs unlawful for us Romans to accept or practice. The crowd joined in the attack against Paul and Silas, and the magistrates ordered them to be stripped and beaten with rods. After they had been severely flogged, they were thrown into prison, and the jailer was commanded to guard them carefully. And when he received these orders, he put them in the inner cell and fastened their feet in the stocks. In upon him, Silas were put in the most inner chamber of the prison, like a dungeon. There was no light there, there was pure darkness, you know, and their feet was, if you really study the law that time in that place, how they usually fasten the feet to the stocks is they will put their legs apart and sometimes put them upside down, you know, to cause them pain, you know. And about midnight, verse 25, about midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. Amen. Come on, tap the person next to you and say, the other prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly, verse 26, come on, say suddenly. There was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened and everyone's chains were loosed. Amen. 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 You see, church, that's the God you and I serve today. You know, let's look at a logic point of view, okay? You know, the verse 20, Paul and Silas, you know, they were labeled city troublemakers, right? They were put in prison, right? But in verse 26, in verse 25, even after enduring avlo upadratha avanga anubichittu avangala vastirangal ellam kilithu potargal avangala vandu bayangaramada adichanga amavaliya andha mari soonalla kuda avangala vandu siraichal kuda avu thooki podumbodhu avanga kaalla katti vikkumbodhu kuda Paul and Silas still praise God. Amen. அவங்க ஜெபம் பண்ணி தேவனை அப்படியாக துதித்து பாடினார்களா? Amen. Amen. You see, in the natural, it is something unheard of and impossible. But it was made possible through the divine intervention of God because of Paul and Silas's attitude of the heart. Amen. Their hearts respond to the time. Come on, you are in prison, you are singing and praising God, and suddenly something that is beyond natural happens. That is, the earthquake, the earth begin to shake, the foundations of the prison begin to shake. Is that something natural? Is that something natural, church? Right, people in the hall? Is that something natural? No. And suddenly all the doors were opened by itself, like as if it's on autopilot or automated. You know, and everyone's chain were loose. Is that something natural? Is that something normal? No, it is something impossible, something unnatural, but it became possible because of a supernatural God. Amen. Amen. You know, and why? Because Paul and Silas's heart responds. The attitude of the heart they had in the midst of their severe persecution and pain. They had gratitude. They remembered the faithfulness of God. They were singing about God. And yet, in their situation, they were faithful to God. Amen. Amen. You know, பால் அண்ட் சைலஸ் வந்து முறுமுறுத்து இருக்கலாங்க, பாலும் சீலாம முறுமுறுத்து இருக்கலாம், இல்லாட்டி அப்படியே கம்ப்ளைண்ட் பண்ணிருக்கலாம், யூனோ எல்லா குறித்தும் அவங்க வந்து கம்ப்ளைண்ட் பண்ணிருக்கலாம். யூனோ பால் கூட ஸ்டேட் பால் சொல்லியிருக்கலாம் அப்படியாக, ஆண்டவரே நான் இங்க வரணும்னு சொல்லவே இல்லை, ஆண்டவரே நீங்க தானே எனக்கு அந்த தரிசனத்தை கொடுத்தீங்க, ஆண்டவரே நான் அங்க போகணும்னு இருந்தேன், நீங்க அங்க ஏசியாக போகாம நீங்க ஆவியானவரே நீங்க தடுத்தீங்க, பைத்தினியாக்க போகாம நீங்க தடுத்தீங்க, நான் இங்க வரணும்னு சொல்லவே இல்லையே. This is not my decision, God. Father, you are the one who, God, you are the one who gave me the vision. You are the one who asked me to come here. God, I listen to you. You know, Paul and Silas could have complained, right? I thought you wanted me to come here to reach out to these people. But see what happened, God? You see, God, I listened to you. Now I end up in prison. Right? Paul and Silas could have said that. right? God, I didn't ask for this. God, I didn't ask for my for me to be stripped in the public. அப்படியாக
Church, can we rejoice at all times? Can we pray without ceasing?
giving thanks in everything. You know why? This is the will of God in Christ Jesus for you and I. Amen. Paul and Silas demonstrated relentless gratitude. Their hearts were intentionally focused on God and His goodness. Amen. Amen. I believe Paul and Silas saw hardship as an opportunity to monitor their own hearts and bring conflicting emotion into submission and give thanks to God in all things. Amen. Amen. You know, church, today everything in your life, let's relate to Paul and Silas' situation. Today everything in your life, no matter what circumstance you may be going through, or no matter what is the point of journey or phase that you're going through in your life right now, everything in your life can be falling apart. Or you may be at the right place doing the right thing with the right attitude, but you do not know why everything is just working against you. Your dreams may be being beaten down. Your relationships may be causing your relationship with your family or your marriage may be causing a public uproar, public humiliation or public shame. People might be talking about people might be talking that something is wrong with your marriage, or people, outsiders, may be finding fault with either of y'all, if you're a husband and wife. You may be going through all these rocky stages in your life. But today I want to encourage you not to give up. Your circumstances may be against you, but what is your heart response today? Not heart, H-A-R-D. What is your heart's response today? Amen? Amen. What is the attitude of our hearts today in the circumstances that we are going through? Amen. Know that the scripture says in verse 25 that when Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, the prisoners were listening to them. Right? The prisoners were listening to them. The prisoners were not just listening to some empty words by empty men. They were listening to words that came deep from deep within them. They were listening to the word, the matter of the word. They were listening to the attitude behind the word. Amen? Amen? Just as the prisoners were listening to Paul and Silas, today the world and the people around you is watching and listening to your words and the attitude of your heart despite all the circumstances you are going through, church. So are we lifting up the name of God, or are we dragging down the name of God with our responses, with our heart responses, and with the attitude of our heart? The world and the people around us are watching. They are listening. They're watching us, how we carry ourselves during this pandemic. They're seeing what are the examples that we're sending. Or during a crisis, how do we behave at the workplace? Or how do we behave in our colleges? Or how do we behave in our schools? How do we behave in our families during difficult circumstances or good circumstances? What are the words that we are speaking? What is the attitude of our heart? What is our heart's response? People are watching and listening. The world is watching and listening, church. You know, in your breakthrough, in your supernatural freedom that you will receive through the divine intervention of God, lies, freedoms, miracles, and breakthrough of many others around you. Amen? It's not just about you and me. It's not about just about your circumstance and my circumstance. Amen? Amen? You know, God's word says in Philippians, if I'm not mistaken, to do everything without grumbling and murmuring. At the same time, Romans 12, verse 12 says, நம்பிக்கையிலே சந்தோஷமாக இருங்கள், உபத்திரவத்தில பொறுமையாக இருங்கள், ஜெபத்திலே உறுதியாக தரித்து இருங்கள். ஆமென். ஆமென். You see, this is what Paul and Silas modeled in their difficult circumstance. இதுதான் போலும் சீலாவும் அந்த சிறைச்சல்ல இருக்கும் பொழுது அவங்க அப்படியாக அவங்களோட வாழ்க்கை ஆக்சன்னால அவங்களோட ஹார்ட் ரெஸ்பான்ஸ்னால அவங்க அப்படியாக செய்து கொண்டார்கள். ஆமென். இன்னைக்கு நீங்க உபத்திரத்தை நீங்க கடந்து போகிறீங்களா, ஒரு புரியாத சூழ்நிலை இல்ல குழப்பத்துக்குள்ள நீங்க ஒரு ரொம்ப டிஃபிகல்டான சர்க்கம்ஸ்டன்ஸ் நீங்க கடந்து போகிறீங்களா, இன்னைக்கு நீங்க அந்த நம்பிக்கையில நீங்க சந்தோஷமாக இருங்கள், உபத்திரத்துல நீங்க கடந்து போகும்போது பொறுமையாக இருங்கள், ஜெபத்துல அப்படியாக நம்ம உறுதியாக தரித்து இருங்கள். ஆமென். ஆமென். You know, just now I said today, the result of your response in everything of your circumstances does not only produce your supernatural breakthrough, but also for those around you. Amen? Amen? You know, one thing, is everybody following me? Yeah, everybody put up your right hand and just say, thank you, Jesus. Say, thank you, Jesus. Father, let me have a grateful heart towards you. Come on, say wherever you are. You know, the beautiful thing about Paul and Silas is, you know, if you read the whole of Acts 16, wherever they were, Paul and Silas, எங்க இருந்தாலும் சரி, அவங்க எந்த தெருவுல இருந்தாலும் சரி, whether they were in the streets, அவங்க அப்படியே பட்டணத்துல அந்த சிட்டிஸ்ல இருந்தாலும், இல்ல சிறைச்சாலை தூக்கி போட்டாலும், பிரிசன்ல தூக்கி போட்டாலும், they made God known everywhere. That's the beauty about them, church. They make God known everywhere. Whether they were in the streets, whether they were in the city, whether they were in the prison, they make God known. Amen. 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 You know, if it's not for Paul and Silas, Lydia's family and the whole household wouldn't have been baptized. Amen. நம்ம ரெண்டு வாரத்து ஆகஸ்ட் 16 தேதி நம்ம என்கேஜ் வீக்கெண்ட் லைவ் செஷன்ல நம்ம பார்த்தோம். போலசிலாசோ கடந்து போறனா அங்க போலனா லீடியாலும் அவளோட குடும்பத்தார அவளோட ஹவுஸ் ஹோலும் அவங்க என்ன சொன்னாங்க, பேப்டிசம், they wouldn't have been baptized. Amen. Amen. And if it's not for Paul and Silas, if அந்த சிச்சுவேஷன்ல அந்த சிறையில அவங்க இருக்கும் பொழுது அவங்க ஜெபித்து ஆண்டவருக்கு துதித்து பாடாம இருந்திருந்தாங்க, அவங்க முறுமுறுத்துக்கு ஆண்டவரை கூட வாக்குவாதம் பண்ணிட்டு ஆண்டவரோட சட்டை போட்டுக்கிட்டு ஆண்டவரை குறை சொல்லிக்கிட்டு இல்ல ஒருத்தர் ஒருத்தர் சட்டை போட்டுருந்தாங்கன்னா, அன்னைக்கு அந்த அற்புதமான காரியங்கள், மனிதன் புத்திக்கு எட்டாத காரியம், மனிதன் பார்வைக்கு புரியாத ஒரு காரியம் அன்னைக்கு நடந்திருக்காதுங்க. ஆதி அன்னைக்கு நடக்கலன்னா அன்னைக்கு அந்த பிலிப்பின் ஜெயிலர் ரட்சிக்கப்பட்டிருக்க மாட்டான், அவன் ரட்சிக்கப்படலன்னா அவனோட வீட்டாரும் ரட்சிக்கப்பட்டிருக்க மாட்டாங்க. You know, that is the secret, the their supernatural breakthrough when God came through for them in their supernatural freedom was also the salvation of the Philippian jailer and his household. Amen. Amen. How many of you are following me? Amen. You know, a grateful heart, always remember this, a grateful heart is positioned to receive the miraculous transformation of seemingly impossible circumstances to a place of possibility. Amen. Amen. இன்னைக்கு நீங்க என்ன உங்களோட என்ன கனவுகளோ சரி, உங்களோட உறவுகளோ சரி, உங்களோட குறித்து உங்க வாழ்க்கை குறித்து என்ன காரியங்கள் அப்படியாக சிறையில போட்டு அடைத்த மாதிரி இருக்குது. Are you feeling like you are in the prison, your dreams are imprisoned, or your dreams are burning, your relationships are suffering? What is that? Then your chains in your life, bondages that needs to be broken, clutches of sickness, what is financial debts, and all the spirit of poverty, what is it that is holding you back? What are the chains that's holding you back? Instead today of complaining, of grumbling, of murmuring and saying, ஆண்டர் எனக்கு இது செய்யல, ஆண்டர் நான் நம்பல, ஆண்டர் என்னை கைவிட்டுட்டாரு, இவர்ல ஒரு ஆண்டவரா என்று சொல்றதோட, நான் இவ்வளவு ஜெபித்தேன் எல்லாமே நான் ஆண்டர் சொல்றது கரெக்ட்
நீங்க அப்படியே என்ன செய்யுங்க எப்பொழுதும் சந்தோஷமாக இருங்கள் எல்லாவற்றிலும் சோஸ்திரம் செய்யுங்கள் நீங்க அப்பொழுது ஆண்டரோட கரத்தை நீங்க பார்ப்பீங்க you will see the divine intervention of god and those impossibilities become possibilities and all the doors that are shut close in your life there will be a supernatural freedom that will come your way all அந்த கட்டுகள் உங்க கட்டல வைத்திருக்கிற காரியங்கள் எல்லாமே அப்படியாக அவந்து போவங்க ஆமென் சரியில்லாத காரியங்கள் நம்ம வாழ்க்கல அதோட அஸ்திபாரங்கள் அப்படியாக அசைக்கப்படும் ஆமென் ஆமென் நீங்க உங்களோட சூப்பர்நேச்சுரல் ஃப்ரீடம் அந்த ப்ராமிஸ நீங்க ரிசீவ் பண்ணும் பொழுது அந்த இம்பாசிபிள் சிச்சுவேஷன் பாசிபிளடா நீங்க பார்க்கும் பொழுது இட்ஸ் நாட் ஓன்லி யூ வில் பி பிளஸ்ட் பட் தி பீப்பிள் அரவுண்ட் யூ யூ டோன்ட் நோ ஹவ் many பீப்பிள்ஸ் பிரேக் த்ரூ அண்ட் மிரக்கிள்ஸ் அண்ட் தே ஆர் சூப்பர்நேச்சுரல் ஃப்ரீடம் டிபெண்ட்ஸ் ஆன் யுவர் ஹார்ட்ஸ் ரெஸ்பான்ஸ் and your attitude of the heart today be at home with your family in school in university wherever god has positioned you can we be people who are marked with a code honor code with the carry honor in our hearts and gratitude for god amen amen you know before I go to the second point One thing you have to know is it is not normal for somebody to get so beaten down publicly humiliated your clothes stripped and everything guys okay and then even after put in prison they were praising god after they were free they had a supernatural strength paul and silas still spoke about the lord to the jailer He got saved and his household got saved and they still had the supernatural strength to go to Lydia's house and encourage the brethren there. Amen? With supernatural freedom comes supernatural strength. Amen? With the divine intervention of God, when your heart's response is, when your attitude of the heart is gratitude, when you are grateful to the faithfulness of God you will not only experience supernatural freedom of or seeing things becoming possible but you will also experience a supernatural strength to do things where the natural mind cannot perceive amen amen and that only comes from God. Number two, a heart of gratitude, one of the dimensions a heart of gratitude positions us to receive, number two, is to receive the promises of God and to see the fullness of the manifestation of the promises of God. Amen? Amen? Amen. One of the dimension is ஆண்டவர் செய்த வாக்குத்தத்தங்கள் நம்ம வாழ்க்கல நம்ம அப்படியாக பெற்றுக்கொள்வோம் பெற்றுக்கொள்றது மட்டுமில்ல அது முழுமையாக வெளிப்படுறது நம்ம வாழ்க்கல நம்ம அது ஃபுல் மேனிஃபெஸ்டேஷன் நம்ம அதை பார்ப்போம் நம்ம எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் பண்ணோம் நம்ம அது கடந்து போவோம் Amen. That is what one of the dimension the heart of gratitude will position you to receive in life. Amen. You see, church, gratitude is not only a life-changing virtue, but it's also a legacy-changing virtue. Amen. If you're taking notes, please write down, gratitude is not only a life-changing virtue, but it is also a legacy-changing virtue that positions us to inherit the promises of God. Amen. Amen. We must realize you know that the promises of spiritual blessings in Christ are for us and for generations after us amen can I hear an amen you know the book of acts chapter 2 verse 39 states that for the promise is to you and to your children and to all who are far off, as many as the Lord our God will call. Amen. அப்போஸ்தலர் ரெண்டாவது அதிகாரம் 39வது வசனத்துல போட்டிருக்குது, வாக்கு தத்தமானது உங்களுக்கும் உங்களோட பிள்ளைகளுக்கும் நம்முடைய தேவனாகிய கர்த்தர் வரவழைக்கும் தூரத்தில் இருக்கிற யாவருக்கும் உண்டா இருக்கிறது என்று சொல்லி அப்படி வருது. ஓகே, சோ நீங்க ஞாபகம் வச்சுக்கோங்க, ஆண்டு கொடுக்கிற வாக்கு தத்தம் உங்களுக்கு மட்டும் இல்லங்க, அது உங்களுக்கும் உங்களோட பிள்ளைகளுக்கும். Amen. Amen. Today recall back what are the promises that God has given you. Amen. The promises is not only for you, but it's also for our children and for the generations after earth. Amen. Amen. What we receive will also touch our children, church, and those connected to earth for generations to come. You know, God does not intend for what He has blessed us with to just stop with our life. ஆண்டவர் நம்மள ஆசீர்வதித்து நம்மள வாழ்க்கையோட நிறுத்தி போறோம்னா அவரு எதிர்பார்க்கவே அவர் நினைக்க மாட்டாரு. You understand God? He is eternal, and what He gives can be passed from one generation to the next like a spiritual inheritance. Amen. Amen. நம்ம இந்த வசனத்தை படிக்கும் போது நம்ம பார்ப்போம் அம்மாவாலியா. You see many stories in the Old Testament especially. You see, when the Apostle Paul writes about the promises of spiritual blessing, he expresses words of praise and thanksgiving to God in response. Amen? It is true. God has given us every spiritual blessing. Yes or no? But how many of us are thanking God for it? How many of us with a heart of gratitude, with a thankful and a grateful heart, how many of us are directing, Father, blessed be your name. Thank you, Lord, for every spiritual blessing that you have given us. But Paul expresses it in Ephesians chapter 1 verses 3. If you read Ephesians chapter 1 verses 3, it states that, Nammer Kartharage Yesu Christ. பிதா ஆகிய தேவனுக்கு சோஸ்திரம். ஆமென். நம்ம கர்த்தராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவின் பிதா ஆகிய தேவனுக்கு சோஸ்திரம். அவர் கிறிஸ்துவுக்குள் உன்னதங்களில் ஆவிக்குரிய சகல ஆசீர்வாதத்தினாலும் நம்மை ஆசீர்வதித்திருக்கிறார். ஆமென். Amen. Can we thank God? You know, in Ephesians chapter 1 verses 3, Apostle Paul states that, Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in heavenly places in Christ. Today, God has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ. But are we grateful? Are we thanking God? Are we saying, Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord? Are we grateful? You see, church, there is a connection between having a grateful heart and assessing the promises of God. Amen? Amen? You know, God could have given you and your family many promises. He could have spoken many promises. But are you recalling this promise? Are you bringing it to your remembrance? Are you glorifying God? Are you thanking God? What is your heart's response today? What is the attitude of our hearts? If we want to receive those promises and see the full manifestation of those promises, the attitude of our heart is very important. Every blessing we could possibly need has been made available to us in the heavens. And gratitude is the key to unlocking it. Amen? Amen? You know the second part. I say, first part is to see the impossible situation becoming possible. Right? Secondly, I said, in a heart of gratitude position us to receive the promises of God. A. Secondly, say still on the second point, the heart of gratitude positions us to also see the fullness of the manifestation of the promises of God in our life. Not only receive the promises, but you also see, experience and walk it and live it out. You see the manifestation of it. Amen? Amen? You know, a grateful heart, church, is the key to enter into all that God has for us. Amen? Is everybody following me? You see, take the Israelites for a... If you have your Bibles with me, we also looked at the scripture about 2 weeks ago on August 16th on Sunday during our Weekend Alive live session. Please turn to Numbers 13. Please turn to Numbers 13 if you have your Bibles with you. Okay? You know, consider the Israelites in the wilderness. Their 11-day journey took them 40 years because of an attitude of ungratefulness. Amen? God gave them a promise. ஆண்டவர் இஸ்ரவேல் புத்திரர்கள் இஸ்ரேல் ஜனங்களுக்கு ஆண்டவர் ஒரு வாக்குத்தத்தம் கொடுத்தாரு. அவர் கானான் தேசத்துக்கு அவங்கள கானான் தேசம் அவங்களுக்கு கொடுப்பாருன்னு சொல்லி ஆண்டவர் வாக்குத்தத்தம் பண்ணாரு. ஆமாவா இல்லையா? அதனால அவங்க எகிப்து தேசத்துல இருந்து ஆண்டவர் அவங்கள மீட்டு அந்த வனாந்தரத்துல ஒரு 11 நாட்கள் ஜேர்னிங்க ஏத்துனவங்க 40 வருஷம் எடுத்துச்சு. அவங்களோட முறுமுறுக்கத்தையும் ஆவினால. They were ungrateful to God. The response of their heart was a bitter, complaining, mentality of fear, and they were constantly murmuring. Even though God has shown them so many signs and wonders in Egypt, God parted the Red Sea for them. And yet, they received the promises of God, but they did not receive the full manifestation of it in their lives. You know, discontentment and temptation to complain crop up when we are more focused on a problem than we are on our God. Amen? A complaining spirit and a mentality of fear wanted to pull the Israelites back into bondage because they wanted to go back to Egypt. Right? For those of you who didn't join our Weekend Alive live session on August 16th, இது ஒரு ஓவியூவாக எடுத்துக்கோங்க. அந்த நேரத்துல ஆண்டர் வந்து மோசே கூப்பிட்டு ஆண்டர் சொன்னாரு, எல்லா கோத்திரத்திலும் ஒரு தலைவன் சூஸ் பண்ணி டேக் எ லீடர் ஃப்ரம் எவ்ரி ட்ரைப் அண்ட் சென்ட் அவுட் மேன் டு ஸ்பை ஆர் தி லேண்ட். சோ மோசஸ் சூஸ் 12 கைஸ் 12 லீடர்ஸ் ஆர் லிசன் டு தி லீடர்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி ட்ரைப் டு ஸ்பை ஆர் தி லேண்ட் ஆஃப் கேனான். ஆமென். And God said, go ask them to spy out the land which I'm giving to the children of Israel. So, wilderness of Paran le irukkum bolude, Paran anandathil irukkum bolude, Mose vandu and panandu pera anpunaru. Andu poi andu desatha poi paathu vaanga, spy pannittu vaanga, anga enna irukku, anga irukku aatkal eppadi irukanga, andu desathil enna odudhu appadi appadi nu solla. Yeah. You know, these people came back after 40 days. Now, for the nas and then, they came back. You know, in verse 13, the beautiful things in Numbers 13, Caleb said, let us go up at once and take possession, for we are able to overcome it. You know, so now, Caleb, we go and go. And that is, we go and go. திட்டவட்டமாக தைரியமாக ஒரு வெற்றிகரமான ஆவியோட அவர் பேசினாரு. Amen. But if you see in verse 21 to 23, following me, right?
Yes.
Okay. You see, the other 10 spies that came back, அந்த 10 ஆண்கள், 12 ஆட்கள்ல 10 பேர் திரும்பி வந்தவங்க, அவங்க என்ன சொன்னாங்கன்னா, அவங்க கம்ப்ளைண்ட் பண்ண ஆரம்பிச்சாங்க, அவங்க முறுமுறுக்க ஆரம்பிச்சாங்க. அந்த தேசத்தை குறித்து ஒரு துர்ச்செய்திய அவங்க கொடுத்தாங்க. ஆமே, அவங்க என்ன சொன்னாங்க, எங்க பார்வையில நாங்க வெட்டிக்கிளிகள் மாதிரி இருந்தோம், எங்க பார்வையில நாங்க வந்து வெட்டிக்கிளி மாதிரிகள் இருந்தோம், அவங்க பாருங்க அப்படிதான் இருந்தோடனே அவங்க துச்சேரி சொன்னாங்க ஓகேயா அவங்க சொல்ல 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 அவங்க கம்ப்ளைண்ட் பண்ண பண்ண அவங்க பேட் ரிப்போர்ட் கொடுக்கும் போது அவங்க மர்மர் பண்ணும் போது நம்ம நம்பர்ஸ் 14ல பார்க்கறோம் எண்ணாகமம் 14வது அதிகாரத்துல பார்க்கறோம் 1ல இருந்து 4வது வசனம் படிச்சீங்கன்னா அங்க என்ன செய்ய ஆரம்பிக்கறாங்க எல்லா இஸ்ரவேல் புத்திரர்களோ இஸ்ரவேல் ஜனங்களோ என்ன செய்ய பார்க்கறாங்க எல்லாருமே மோசஸ்க்கும் ஆரோனுக்கும் எதிராக திரும்பி அவங்கள மோசஸ்க்கும் ஆரோனுக்கும் எதிராக கம்ப்ளைன்ட் பண்ண ஆரம்பிக்கறாங்க ஆத்திரப்பட்டாங்க முறுமுறுத்தாங்க எல்லாரும் குரலை உயர்த்தி ராத்திரி பூரா அழுதாங்க இன்னோ அப்படியே அழுதாங்க அப்புறம் அவங்க சொன்னாங்க நம்மளுக்கு ஒரு தலைவனை நம்ம ஏற்படி நம்ம திருப்பி எகிப்து தேசத்துக்கே போலாம் ஆண்டர் யான நம்ம எங்களை கொண்டு வந்தாரு எங்க சாவடிக்கு அந்த நாட்டுக்கு போய் அங்க சாவணும்னு சொல்லி தான் கொண்டு வந்தாரான்னு ரொம்ப முறுமுறுத்தார்கள் பாருங்க ஆண்டவர் அவ்வளவு காரியங்கள் நன்மைகள் அற்புதங்கள் அவங்களுக்கு எகிப்து தேசத்திலையும் செய்து அந்த ரெட் சீயும் ஆண்டர் பிளந்த ஆண்டு அவங்கள கொண்டு வந்த தேவன் உண்மையுள்ள தேவனாக இருந்தார் ஃபேத்ஃபுல்லாக இருந்தார் பட் யட் திஸ் பீப்பிள் வாஸ் சோ அன்கிரேட்ஃபுல் ஈவன் சீயிங் வித் தியர் ஐஸ் ஆல் தி வண்டர்ஸ் அண்ட் மிரக்கிள்ஸ் ஆஃப் காட் தே ஸ்டில் குடன் அந்த அந்த இடத்துல அவங்க நின்னு சொல்லிருக்கலாம் இவ்வளவு இவ்வளவு நாட்கள் ஆண்டு நம்மள வழி நடத்தின தேவன் இந்த தேசத்தையும் ஆண்டவர் வழி நடத்துவார் ஆண்டு நம்மளோட இருக்கிறார் அவங்க சொல்லிருக்கலாம் But அந்த நேரத்துல they were all complaining and murmuring and crying you know but numbers 14th அதிகாரம் 7ல இருந்து 9வது வசனத்துல நம்ம பார்த்தோம்னா யோசுவாவும் காலேபும் மட்டும் பக்கத்துல பார்த்து சொல்லுங்க யோசுவா அண்ட் காலே பார்த்தோம் அவங்க அந்த தேசத்தை குறித்து அந்த அந்த இடத்தை பத்தி நல்ல செய்தி கொடுத்தாங்க They said it's an exceedingly good land. The Lord is with us. We do not need to fear them. We can go and take possession of the place. Amen. And how did these people react? They wanted to stone Joshua and Caleb, right? And you see in verse 23 to 24. இன்னாகமம் 14வது அதிகாரம் 23 24வது வசனம் படித்தோம்னா 10 times You know, why does these people still put me to test? Why does these people do not heed my voice? Indirectly, God was saying, why these people are always complaining? Why these people are complaining against me? Bringing complaint against me? Indirectly, God is saying, why are they so ungrateful? You know, have you ever thought how much it would have burdened God? How much it would have troubled the heart of our Father? How much it would have hurt God that He actually said, why do they reject me? How long more do I have to bear with these people who complain against me? How long do I need to bear with the complaints that these children of Israel make against me? Can you see? How long will they reject me? Why don't they heed my voice? I've shown them so many signs and wonders. I brought them through the Red Sea. But what, you know, God just exposed what was in his heart. Right? And because of that, because of their complaining spirit, because of their murmuring, despite everything that God has done for them, God being with them literally throughout their journey, God said they won't see the land he swore to their fathers as a result of their complaining and grumbling. You know? But in verse 24, come on, everybody say verse 24. If you have your Bibles, put your finger in verse 24. You know? In verse 24, God said, But my servant Caleb, because he has a different spirit in him has followed me fully. I will bring into the land where he went, and his descendants shall inherit it. You see, this promise of this promised land was for all the children of Israel, right? The promise was received by their fathers for all of them, literally. But because of their ungratefulness and complainings and murmurings, the complaints they brought up against God, their unbelief, you know, they could not enter into the land which was promised or sworn to their fathers. But instead, Caleb and his descendants and Joshua went into the land. Amen. The promise was for all of them, yet only two carried a spirit that will allow them to enter into the promised land, claim their spiritual destiny, and connect generations to a new spiritual legacy. Amen. Amen. You see, church, Joshua and Caleb had seen the very same land and the very same people. Yet they reported that the land was exceedingly good. The extremely different perspectives came from a heart filled with gratitude, as opposed to complaint. The other 10 spies were complaining, were murmuring, but Joshua and Caleb had a heart of gratitude. They encouraged the Israelites to take hold of God's promise. They even say, let us go now and take possession. Amen. Amen. They saw the land through the perspective of God's faithfulness. They saw from the perspective of God's faithfulness, and they responded based on a heart that is grateful to God's faithfulness. Amen. Amen. The Israelites could have defeated doubt with gratitude, yet they gave in to complaint, ungratefulness, and quickly forgot everything that God did for them. And I said, so the answer to response in Navagir, right? Following me? Now, church. Now, what are the promises that God has spoken over you and have given you? Take hold of the promises of God. Begin to thank God with a thankful heart. Bring God to remembrance of His promise and not our problems. Amen. இவ்வளவு நாட்கள் நம்மளை வழி நடத்தின தேவன், இவ்வளவு நாட்கள் நம்மளோட கரத்தை பிடித்து நம்மளோட கடந்து வாழ்க்கை பயணத்தை கடந்த தேவன் இன்னமும் நம்மளை வழி நடத்தி கொண்டுதான் இருக்கிறாருங்க. ஆமென். நம்மளோட வாழ்க்கை பயணத்துக்கு முன் நம்மள முன் போடுறதே ஆண்டவர் தான். ஆமென். சோ லெட்ஸ் பிரிங் காட் டு ரிமெம்பரன்ஸ் ஆஃப் ஆல் த வாக்கு தத்தம். அவர் பேசின எல்லா வாக்கு தத்தமும் நம்ம குறித்து அதை நம்ம நினைவு கூறுவோமா? Let's remember all the good things God has done. Amen. Amen. You know, and don't, let's not bring God to remembrance of our problems. He knows them. He knows them. But He will make a way out of them. Amen. Today, what's our heart response, church? Are we going to say, like the spies? Namma andha 10 spy mari nammoda response kudukka poruma? ஐயோ என்னோட பிரச்சனை ரொம்ப பெருசா இருக்குது, என் பிரச்சனை தலைக்கு மேல மலைக்கு மேல பெரிய பிரச்சனை, ஐயோ அந்த கடன் என்னால அடைக்க முடியல, அது ரொம்ப ரொம்ப நான் ரொம்ப விழுந்துட்டேன். Are you limiting God with your statements? Are you limiting God with your bad statements? Despite the promises that God has given over your life. இன்னைக்கு நம்ம என்ன பேசிக் கொண்டிருக்கிறோம்? Oh, this problem is too big. I can't overcome that. But when the word of God, when the promise of God, it is what already said that you and I are overcomers. That you and I are more than conquerors. So when the word of God says we are more than conquerors, are we still sitting down and saying, you know, I cannot overcome the problem, it's too big? What is our heart's response today? Are we going to say, God, I know you are faithful. God, I know you brought me through that temptation, that fear, and I overcome it, God. Father, I know this mountain is not too big for you. This problem is not too big for you. This fear is not big for you. I know I will overcome it because your word says that I am more than a conqueror. That is the promise of God, church. Take hold of the promises of God. And thank God and be grateful to God, and you and I will see the full manifestation of that promise coming to pass. Amen. Amen. Today, what is our response? Are we going to respond like the 10 spies, or are we going to respond like Joshua and Caleb? Amen. And today, what will God's response be to us when He observes our response in the midst of our circumstances? Amen. Will He look at you and I and say, after all His faithfulness in our life, throughout our lifetime, will He look at us and say, why are you rejecting me? You know, why do you reject me? How long do I need to bear, you know, with you complaining against me? God is long-suffering and patience, yes, people of God. But do we choose to continue hurting God with our unbelief towards His faithfulness? Or are we just going to proclaim His goodness and faithfulness in our life? When we operate with a response of a heart that is grateful, and when gratitude is the attitude of our heart, we will not only receive the promise, but we will also see the fullness of the manifestation of the promises of God in our lives. Amen. Amen. Will God say, why are you so ungrateful? Why are you rejecting me? Why don't you heed my voice? What will be God's response to us when He observes us, observes our heart's responses today as we go through various circumstances in life? What will God say? Or will He say, Sarah? Or will He say, Lawrence? You know, will He say, Juliana, my servant, my daughter, who has a different spirit in him or her? What will God's response be today? Amen? Church, let's be a people that will carry that measure, that different kind of spirit. We carry the Spirit of God. Let's carry the spirit of excellence. Amen? Just know that the Spirit of God is resting upon you, and God's hand of blessing is upon your head, and no one on earth or no enemy in hell can undo what God has accomplished for you on the cross. Amen. Jesus died so you and I might live a victorious life. Today, God's hand of blessing is upon your head and my head, and the Spirit of God is resting upon us. Amen. Amen. So we are people who carry the Spirit of God. We are the people with the spirit of excellence in us. We are the people with a different spirit in us. So we have to function and respond in our circumstances from a place of thankfulness. Amen. Amen. Gratitude should be the attitude of our heart. Thankfulness should be our heart response, irrespective of our circumstance. And you see, God's favor will begin to manifest in your lives, in our lives. Amen. Amen. And lastly, a heart of gratitude will position us to receive, and it will enable us to maintain, enable us to maintain an intimate relationship with God and healthy relationship with others. I'm not going to go through this today. The third point, I'll speak from Psalms 100 and verse 4 and some other scriptures of how we go to a place of deeper intimacy in God, and how to maintain and develop an intimacy with God, and how to maintain a healthy relationship with others
with whoever we are doing life with in our life. Amen. I'll speak to you about that on September 6th for our Weekend Alive live sessions and our engaged group basis, and we will also serve communion at the time. So I'll cover that third point on September 6th. Alright? So today, church, the point 1 and 2. Today, can we choose to be like Paul? And can we choose to be like Silas? Can we choose to be like Joshua and Caleb? Amen? Amen? I think I've spoken much in length about Paul and Silas and also about Joshua and Caleb. Today, what is the attitude of our heart? Today, what is the response of our heart? Is it gratitude? Is it thankfulness? Or are we operating from a spirit of complaining, murmuring, or mentality of fear? இன்னைக்கு நம்மளோட இருதயத்தினோட பொசிஷன் எப்படியாக இருக்குது? நம்ம நன்றி உள்ளத்தோட ஜனங்களாக இருக்கிறோமா இல்ல முறுமுறுக்கிற ஜனங்களாக நம்ம இருக்கிறோமா? இன்னைக்கு நம்ம கடந்து போகிற ஒவ்வொரு சூழ்நிலையும் நம்ம எப்படி நம்ம ரெஸ்பாண்ட் பண்ணுகிறோம், அந்த ரெஸ்பாண்ட ஆண்டர் பார்த்து கொண்டிருக்கிறார். அண்ட் ஆண்டர் நம்மளை பார்க்கும் போது, what will God respond to us? Amen. Today, whatever promises that God has given you, when you have a thankful heart, you will not only receive the promises of God, but you will see the fullness, the manifestation of the promise of God in your life, like Joshua and Caleb. Amen. Amen. We are people with a different spirit. Church, let us be a people with a different spirit. Amen. With a spirit of excellence. Know that the Spirit of God is resting upon you. Amen. Amen. அப்படியாக நீ இருக்கிற இடத்துல எல்லாரும் கரங்களை உயர்த்தி அப்படியாக ஜெபம் பண்ணுவோம். அப்படியாக ஆண்டுக்கு நம்ம நன்றி செலுத்துவோமாக. ஓ ஷிக்கியாச்சாரமா சாந்தா. You know, church, even before we go to our third point, I'll be speaking on September 6th. But as a conclusion, I'll just leave this with you. Colossians chapter 4 verse 2 states that இடை விடாமல் ஜெபம் பண்ணுங்கள், சோஸ்திரத்துடன் ஜெபத்தில் விழித்திருங்கள். நீங்க இன்னைக்கு என்ன கடந்து போனாலும் சரி, உங்க வாழ்க்கை பயணத்துல நீங்க என்ன கடந்து போனாலும் சரிங்க, ஆண்டவர் உங்களுக்கு துணையாக நிற்கின்றார். இன்னைக்கு நீங்கள் நானும் அப்படியாக இடைவிடாமல் ஜெபம் பண்ணுவோம், சோஸ்திரத்தோட நம்ம ஜெபத்துல அப்படியாக விழித்திருப்போம், நிலைத்திருப்போம். ஆமென், ஆமென். இது ஆண்டவரோட இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவின் சுத்தமாக நம்மளோட வாழ்க்கையில இருக்குது. ஆமென், ஆமென். Let us be thankful to God at all times for everything. ஆமென். சோ அப்படியாக நம்ம ஜெபம் பண்ணுவோம், ஆண்டவரோட every promise that you have spoken over our lives, oh Father. God, we know, God, that you have spoken in your word that every spiritual blessings, oh God, in the heavenly places, oh God, you have blessed us, oh God, in Christ Jesus. And today, oh Father, we bless your holy name, oh God. We glorify your name, oh God. We thank you, oh Father. We adore you, oh Father. We thank you for all the things that you have done and all the things that you're going to do, oh Father. Father, today, help us to be a people, oh God, that will respond with a heart of thankfulness, with a heart of gratitude, oh God. Father, if in our lives, if we have complained and if we have murmured against you, knowingly or unknowingly, today, Father, we come before you humbly and we ask forgiveness, oh God. Forgive us, oh God, for our ignorance, oh Father. God, today, oh Father, we align back our hearts to you, oh Father God.
And Father, we pray, oh God, as Paul and Silas, oh Father, help us, oh Father, to respond to you, oh God, with praise and thanksgiving, oh Father God, and praying without ceasing, oh God, no matter what our circumstances, oh God, demand from us, oh Father. And Father, help us to be like Joshua and Caleb, oh God, people with a different spirit, oh Father God. Father, we choose, oh God, today to honor you, oh Father, with the attitude of our hearts. We choose to honor you, oh God, with thankfulness, oh Father. Father, even as this week, oh Father, we go through this coming new week, oh Father. Father, help us, oh God, to reflect back on this word and relate back to every situation and circumstance in our life according to the standard of your word, oh Father. We want to be grateful people, oh God. People that will not complain or murmur, but people that will lift you up in praise, that will lift up the banners of praise of your name, oh God. And Father, I pray for everyone tuned to this stream, oh Father, that every person, oh God, that responds, oh Father, with a heart of gratitude, oh Father, who's thankful, oh Father. Father, I pray, oh God, that we as a family, all of us, oh Father, will see, oh Father, impossible is becoming possible, oh Father God, because of your divine intervention, oh Father. We will see situations being miraculously transformed, oh God. Things that that cannot happen naturally will happen supernaturally because you are a supernatural God, oh Father. Father, we will see supernatural freedoms taking place, not just ours, but people connected to us, oh Father. And God, I pray, oh Father, that we will not only just receive the promises that you have spoken over our lives and for our children of our generation, oh Father, but we will see the fullness of its manifestation, oh Father. We thank you, oh God. Father, I pray that this week will be full of signs, wonders, breakthroughs, miracles, oh God. And we will begin to feel your presence in a more tangible way, oh Father. And we will draw closer and closer to you and fall in love with only you, Jesus. And we will journey, oh God, these coming days with a grateful heart and a thankful heart's response, oh God, and attitude of the heart. Father, we commit every person connected to this dream. We pray for your hand of protection. Father, Father, we know that your presence has gone before us and you give us rest, oh God. Father, I know that your presence is with us, oh Father. I thank you, Lord. We give you all the glory and honor. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you, church, for your time. It's been truly an honor and pleasure to speak to you the word of God. I pray that this coming week you will just continue to seek God and journey through life being grateful for the faithfulness of God. Remember all the good things that He has done for you. Amen. We miss you so much, church. We love you. I'm praying for you. I'm really praying for all of you, each one of you. You know, till we meet again, stay sheltered under the shadow of the Almighty, for there is no better place to be. Take care, church. Stay connected. God bless you. I will thank you, Lord. I will thank you, Lord.